be with you are all the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
We are so glad that you are all joining us tonight on this most holy night, Christmas Eve at Lake Park Lutheran Church. We know that many of you are joining us online, so you can say hello to the folks in the cameras. We give thanks for the ways that technology allows us to be knit together, not just in community here, but with all those who are joining us around the country and maybe even around the world tonight. So we give thanks for that. Today we know that interruption and disruption has entered into our world yet again, and I know many of you have made changes to holiday plans. There's a lot of weariness in our world. And so tonight we gather with hope to cry out this story once again, the birth of Jesus Christ, our Savior, who comes to bring love and new life into this world. So whether you're here or huddled at home, know we're so glad to be with you all and to share in this night together. We hope you participate, obviously, if you're here. But even if you're at home, please do sing along with us. Make sure to have a candle to light later in the service, so that we can be together truly tonight. Let's begin our service in prayer. You'll find the prayer in your bulletin. Let us pray. Almighty God, you
made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
You can be seated for the reading.
The reading tonight comes from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them a light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken, as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish it and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
On a night like this, when the wind was still, a star came out above a lonely hill. On a night like this, there was not a sound to break the peace on the cold, hard ground. On a night like this, all the world looked down on a peaceful town cradled in snow. And the yellow moon cast a glow that found all the men and beasts huddled below, round a sweet little baby lying in a manger, looking up at strangers with gifts in their hands, not knowing he was meant to be the hope of humanity. troubled land. On a night like this, all the world looked down on a peaceful town cradled in snow. And a yellow moon cast a glow that found all the men in peace huddled below. Round a sweet little baby strangers who came from afar, just a child like you and me, full of hope and full of need, or was he just a rash to see from a wandering star? On a night like this, on a
Gospel for this Christmas Eve is taken from Luke, the second chapter. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered, and Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Now in that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord, and this will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You can be seated. These words are from Martin Luther, who preached a Christmas Eve sermon about 500 years ago. The Christmas gospel is very clear. There is little need of learned interpretation. It is only necessary to ponder it well, to contemplate it, to take it completely into your heart. None will derive more benefit from it than those whose hearts hold still and who divest themselves of material considerations and concentrate diligently on it. Christmas is like the sun. In a placid pond, it can be seen clearly. and it warms the water powerfully. But in a rushing current, it cannot be seen as well, nor can it warm up the water as much. So, if you wish to be illumined on Christmas Eve and warm your heart, if you wish to see God's mercy and wondrous deeds so that your hearts are filled with fire and light and become reverent and joyous, then go to where you may be still and impress the picture deep in your heart. There you will find no end to the wondrous deeds of Christmas. Be still. Be still. It's almost an impossible thing right now, isn't it? Be still. In the ever-accelerating race of crisis after crisis after crisis, after schedule, after rearranging, the constant media saturation of yet one more thing after another, it rustles up our collective soul rivers and makes them frothy and turbulent. Never stillness. You try to plan stillness, intentionally simplify your Christmas this year. And then Delta, and then Omicron, and then all the other chaos. Our angels were decimated this year from the Christmas pageant. One after another, they fell like flies this morning from the sky. Even Mary and Joseph were taken out. We had to substitute them in with others. Be still. Look at the shepherds there in the field. They weren't the focus of anything. They were outcast, working class, pawns in the economic system. Look at them. The angels sang to them. Look at Joseph. Joseph, an old man who dreamed dreams and never thought the dreams would land in his heart. And yet, somehow, on this night, he's chosen. An angel speaks to him. Look at Mary, young and forgotten, told that her very body was impure by a culture, told exactly what she needed to do with her body by the culture. And then, all of a sudden, that very thing which was called wrong was blessed by God. Look at the animals. Why are the animals there? Animals aren't a part of salvation. Do they get to be part of God's plan as well? Why look at these things in stillness? Well, maybe if we slow down enough, maybe if we have a night like tonight, maybe we can see the perplexing, mysterious wonder of what's really going on in all of it. Maybe if we're quieted enough, maybe we can see how God really works. Everything that is messed up is the very place where God works beauty. Everything that is broken is the very place where God makes wondrous things. Everything that is fallen, that is lost, that is hurting or suffering, everything that is weak and fragile, this is the place where love thrives. There are a few advantages to being 22 years as a pastor of a church. You accumulate over time stories about people. You grasp onto yourself all these facts about what really makes people people, and you remember them. And so, when you see said person up there ringing the bells, you don't just hear the ringing of the bells, you think of all those conversations you had with her who was leading the health, public health response to COVID for the last 2 years and was worn weary with fear of all of us getting sick and somehow managed to make it all okay in some simple way. And there she is, right there, ringing the bells. And then you see the person right next to her, and you know that she just took her mom to the hospital, afraid that she was having a massive stroke, but really it was just shingles. And she put all that aside, and she goes and grabs the next set of bells right there. And then you see this person up there, Lori, she's running around, and she's leading the choir, and she's playing the organ, and then she's up here, right there, doing the bells. And you think of the fact that about 20 years ago, where said child, who you just had a conversation with in the hall out there, because she's back from college and she's totally exhausted, because for some reason, as a freshman, she scheduled all of her classes at 8 in the morning. She'll learn. But you remember that when that said child was born, it created this tumor in Lori's brain, and she almost died. It took over 20 years to kill the tumor so that she can be up there playing. And then you see this guy, and he's right there, and you remember the first time you talked with this guy, and he was just recovering from a stroke himself. He had fallen off the upper floor of his house here on the east side, and he was almost dead. And he actually had to learn how to play guitar again. He learned it all perfectly as a kid, and then he fell and had the accident, and he had to learn it all over again. And every time I see his little hands on the guitar strings, I feel like what a delicate, precious thing it is that he's actually alive. And then you look at this other guy over here, and he organized the bells, and you know that he was told for a whole generation down in a conservative church that he was nothing, and that he wasn't worthy of God's love because of who he loved. And you know that somehow he was told something else, and he actually believed it. And then what was stifled down inside could grow and thrive. And then he's silly and playful, and all of us laugh because he makes music with us. And then you know that this person, she should have been a social worker, but somehow God plucked her away from all that, told her that she should be a pastor, and she's dancing there, filling in the parts of all those angels who were decimated earlier. And you realize it's true. This thing called the incarnation, this reality of the mighty power and majesty of God, that it truly works in broken and fragile people. You hear it when she gets up and plays such a beautiful song on the piano, and you know, and you just wonder at how she can do it, because just this year she lost her boy way too young, but she can still play the piano with joy and sing praises to God on high. And you look at the windows, and you know that that window was given by a family who'd lost their son in warfare, and that window was given by someone who lost a political battle that was really, really fraught, but somehow they lost, but they still decided to give money to the church, even though they lost the political battle. Because there's always political battles. And you know that that organ was made by someone who, again, was told that he wasn't loved by the church, but then discovered that this church loved him, and so he built an organ for it. Christmas is about God being born in a fragile, subtle world that is not strong and powerful, but that is tender enough, supple enough, dexterous enough, joyful enough to hold even the most tenderest of things. We've been ravaged these last 2 years, utterly ravaged. We feel the tenderness palpable on our tongue. This is a beautiful and good thing. It's called the incarnation. And God redeems worlds with the taste of it. Amen. One of the victims of COVID was my beloved choir director, died way too young. His favorite song was In the Bleak Midwinter. I know, it seems strange, but it was, because the song is about exactly what I was talking about. Let's sing it. We're going to go and sing it right from the middle aisle. I'm going to grab the stand. I need a stand. We're going to play it a cappella without any sound system, because we've been playing on sound systems for 2 years now, and it's annoying. Bring it around for me. Yeah.
Child is this who laid to rest on Mary's lap, happy sleeping, whom angels greet with anthem sweet, while shepherds watch our keeping.
Of ways. So God, we pray, come and be born into our world again and hear the prayers on our hearts. Almighty God, we pray for our hurting world and for all places of pain, violence, persecution, war, and conflict. We pray especially for Bethlehem, a real place in the Holy Land, for peace to reign. Love incarnate, you came to bring restoration. We pray for our community and for all people and places across the globe that are reeling with anxiety, fear, and frustration as COVID cases rise once again. Be with our strained healthcare systems and give rest to healthcare workers. Comfort those whose holiday plans have changed, and hold tight to those who are huddled at home. Emmanuel, God with us, we pray for those for whom this night is tender, for all of us really. Be with those who are missing loved ones. Wrap your arms around those who grieve. Be with those who are sick. And come near to those who are celebrating this holiday amidst complex family systems and painful memories. Challenging circumstances. Christ, you entered into this world as a baby. Bless parents who are strapped for cash and wish they could give more to their little ones. Give rest to new and expectant parents and caregivers. Help parents who are exhausted. and grant comfort to those who long to have children. Pour out your love upon families of every single kind this Christmas. We lift up the prayers in our own community. If you've texted some in, we hope that we receive them, but if we don't, we are praying for them. And for the prayers on our hearts that we say aloud or silently now. God, hold these prayers. Fill us with the love of Christmas. Help us to welcome the Christ child into our midst and inspire us to proclaim the good news of Jesus' birth to all. We commend these prayers to you, confident of your grace and love made known to us in Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Also with you.
I invite you to safely share the peace in ways that are comfortable to you, for those of you here, and those of you online, we invite you to text a loved one or to put something in the chat. The peace of Christ, please share.
Savior so mild, won't you come to me? Shepherds out in the field, sky so surreal, won't you come guide me? I sit watching the news, wondering how the world will ever be made new. It's got me a little sad, but Mary, you can help. You made the babe so glad. Stars shining so bright, wise men's delight, won't you shine for me? Angels sing out so loud, your gathering crowd, won't you sing for me? 'Cause I came back to church tonight to see the tree candle shining bright. And I want to know if it can be that if I'm here, Christmas could find me. 'Cause Christmas keeps growing all through the years. Work and peace, hope, life, and good cheer. Christmas keeps growing all through the years. It'll find you tonight. Mary, with your little child, Savior, somehow, won't you come to me? Angels sing out so loud, your gathering crowd, won't you sing for me? 'Cause I came back to church tonight to see the tree candle shining bright, and I want to know if it can be that if I'm here, Christmas could find me. 'Cause Christmas keeps growing all through the years, work and peace, hope, life, and good cheer. Christmas keeps growing all through the years, it'll find you tonight and wipe away your fears. They say he came to make things right. They say it's God you see in the stillness of the night. And I want you to remember this, 'cause it's the way of truth and happiness. Came as a child, simple and small, soft in a crazy world, calling to us all in hope that tonight everyone would see. Let the story grows on to find you and me. Christmas keeps growing all through the years, spreading hope in the wilderness for all who yearn to hear. Christmas keeps growing all through the years, it'll find you tonight and wipe away your fears. Mary, with your little child, Savior so mild, won't you come to me?
Let's play something.
I invite you to stand for communion.
It is Christmas Eve night, and we are gathered in one holy communion. And whether we are separated by space or time or digital or in person, we remember that you, O God, can overcome all those divisions. You can knit us together into your holy people. You came as a child, simple and small, but you lived and breathed and healed and worked miracles in this world. You grew up and you took bread and you broke it in front of us so that our world might be redeemed.
So we remember that night when Jesus was gathered with his disciples before he was betrayed. He took bread, blessed it, and broke it, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people. Do this in remembrance of me. It's for the forgiveness of sins."
So come, Holy Spirit, bind us together as your people of God, and be with us as we pray together the prayer you taught us. God, you are our mother, but you are also our Father in heaven. Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, deliver us from evil, For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. God's table is here prepared. All are welcome. As you come forward, you'll come up down the center aisle, and Pastor Alyssa and I will give you a little sanitized version of our body and blood of Christ. There is a wafer on top, but there's grape juice on the bottom. You can feel free to take this back, and you can partake here in church, or if you feel more comfortable, you can also take it home and do it. If you are online, we encourage you to share and say these words together with your family, with your elements that you have at home. The table is prepared. All are welcome. Thanks be to God. You can be seated.
You to stand.
And now may this body and blood of the incarnate Christ come and keep us in God's peace. Amen.
Amen. In a world of disruption and plans that somehow didn't work out, this beautiful song, Silent Night, Holy Night, was born. In St. Nicholas Church in the Oberndorf, Austrian Alps, the song was written. The priest and the lead musician were very good friends, and so when the organ went out, the priest asked his friend, who was a good guitar player, to write a song for the church that they could sing in four-part harmony. The song that the musician wrote, Silent Night, Holy Night, it's become this example of beauty born out of plans gone awry, beauty that comes in the midst of a fragile world. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright. Let's sing it. Let's sing the first verse in German, why don't we?
Stille Nacht, heilige Nacht, alle schläft, einsam wach, nur das Totenkopf, heilige
dawn of redeeming grace.
going to invite you to bring this light out into the world. So I'll invite you to process with me, actually, outside, as we bring the light of Christ into a weary world. So now go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.